Shine In, the Jackie Russo. She
wow.
is here.
What an intro.
Hello.
Hello, good morning.
Good How morning to ya? You.
I am well, thanks. It was a good weekend for Caden Sports.
It was. We had Stevie P in here earlier, and you know what happens is, I mean, it's fun. It's fun to go as a fan,
sure.
Okay? But it's a lot more when you go to work, and you have to get there and make sure your equipment mm-hmm. is set up and, you know, everything. And so we were talking to him earlier, and he was like, and what I said, how was your trip to Alabama? It was terrible. I said, but they did what? Well. He was like, I'm just tired. And I said, so where are you going next weekend? Statesboro, Georgia. It's going to be terrible.
And
you
then
know
he goes,
sports guys. That's
like,
just how they are.
He's like, I love Lafayette, man.
Yeah, like, I love it. I live here. I want
to
be here.
It's hard to be on the road. I was listening to baseball, and Jay Walker was saying that there were a big crowd at Troy of 800. And I thought, ooh, we're averaging 5,000.
Yes. Yes. Well, and you kind of realize that when you go, I mean, baseball and softball, when like, a couple weekends ago, my brother and sister-in-law were in from College Station. Okay, so they live maybe 200 yards from Texas A&M. I mean, that's where their house is. They
nice.
Go to everything and whatever. So it was a baseball day, but the time didn't kind of work out. So I said, we'll go to a softball game. I haven't been to one since I went to UL. So let's go ahead and go. They walked in. They were like, oh my gosh,
mm-hmm.
this is the softball
mm-hmm.
field.
Right.
And they're like, we go to Texas A&M baseball games, and guess where the softball field is? Right across the street, and there are no stands. People sit in chairs.
Right.
And, you know, we're so lucky to have that right here.
Oh, we
awesome.
Are. Lamson Park is gorgeous. Russo Park is gorgeous.
Yes.
We have some amazing facilities. And I think it's a, you know, chicken or an egg scenario. Do we have great facilities because we have great fans, or do we have great fans because
right.
we have great facilities?
It's a great place to go.
I think it's all because we have great teams and great coaches.
I'll tell you this. I mean, growing up where we just had the minor league Zephyrs in New Orleans.
Right.
The baby cakes.
I can't talk about that. I'm horrified.
Now, we would go to those games. But to me, the Raging Cajuns baseball games are just as exciting. So,
if not more so.
Yeah, I agree with you. The fans are all invested. It's great.
Yeah.
How is the park coming along?
It's beautiful. I mean, every time we go, you know, there's
they
another thing done.
They do a lot
done.
Of work.
They get a lot done from weekend to weekend.
Yeah.
And so when we go this weekend, it'll have been 2 weeks since we were there mm-hmm. for Houston and Tulane, you know, week and a half. So it'll be interesting to see how much more has been done. I heard Jay talking this weekend. There are 300,000 bricks on that thing.
Wow.
Or there will be when they're done.
Yeah.
That's a lot of bricks.
That is a lot of bricks. So what are we talking about this week in the blog?
Well, you know, I'm not sure if you've been following the story about Brad's wife.
Yes.
But that's what we're talking about
Bernie,
today.
Bernie, you weren't here for Brad's wife, were you?
I was not.
You?
No, I'm sorry.
So,
tell me.
A quick catch up.
Sure.
Brad's wife worked at Cracker Barrel.
Okay.
11 for 11 years.
Years. 11.
I was.
Were you here?
Yes, I was here. I'm sorry.
So she worked there for 11 years.
Yes.
She was let go.
I, too, want to know
and
why.
Right.
Her husband took to social media and basically said, like, why? She's worked there for this long. She's given it this much, whatever. It's now turned into this enormous social media thing
yeah.
where if you know
Everybody.
If you go to the Cracker Barrel Wikipedia page,
oh, yes.
it says number of employees, 70,000
minus
Brad's
wife.
So what can we learn from this?
Well, a couple of things. First and foremost, Cracker Barrel maybe should have kept Brad's wife on. I don't know. She could have been the greatest manager or the worst
manager.
But she
could have been terrible.
She could have
and
been
sometimes
awful.
You have to
that's
make
right.
HR
They could have
decisions.
Just been tolerating it. She may be skimming from the till. Who knows what Brad's wife was
right.
up to.
We don't know.
Right. But the problem
Taking
is
those
she probably should get a job now as their social media manager.
Right.
Because they blew it big time. When it started and Brad originally posted, that should have been the perfect time for whoever's in charge of their social media to yeah. say, hey, let's talk about this offline. I've sent you a direct message.
Mm-hmm.
And deal
mm-hmm.
with it directly mm-hmm. and personally and completely at that time. But they didn't.
They
and
just let it kind
of
hang.
As of this morning, they still haven't responded to Brad
oh.
or the what is now hundreds of thousands of people who have been just trolling their page.
And you're talking about other restaurants?
Oh, yes.
I mean, you know the signs of the removable letters?
Yes.
I mean,
the Chick-fil-A one?
No, I didn't see
so
Chick-fil-A.
So Chick-fil-A, I think in Georgia, said, now hiring, somebody tell Brad's wife.
Yep, that's awesome.
You know, I thought the first thing, how do you, and here's the unfortunate part, and I think it's a common problem that companies make. They think social media is kind of this up-and-coming new thing, so let's put our up-and-coming employees that
sure.
mm-hmm. you don't give them too much to run with, and they're just going to handle it, okay? That I think this whole situation, it means so much more if you have a senior
yeah.
vice president that manages your social media who's going to be more willing to say, respond. You know, not they may not be the one tweeting, but someone needs to be looking out to give the people who are in charge of it the go-ahead to do it. Because if I'm some 22-year-old new grad, maybe started there 6 months ago, oh, I don't want to get involved in this. You know, and
well,
it's a culture
thing. Well, because they haven't been empowered. And so legal, I am certain, has said, don't say anything. It'll blow over eventually. Not realizing it's building steam, not slowing down. And so I think that the under 30 tends to be the appropriate employee because they've got the tech skills. Mm-hmm. They've got the wherewithal. They understand social media. They would never do what Cracker Barrel's been doing, yep, which is continuing to auto-post, hey, this is our pancakes. Fresh
right.
maple syrup.
Yeah.
Come in and eat our pancakes.
But empower your 30-somethings
yes.
right.
to make decisions and know how to handle
yeah,
it.
Yeah, so it's training. It's training and planning. As with everything, it's having a process.
You know, there was some meme, because you know the internet is so great when things
oh,
happen
so
like
great.
This. And it was like an old lady, I mean, white-haired old lady wearing an apron, sitting in one of the rocking chairs on the front, and